Here are the pistons that we're going to be running on the LS1 RX7. They're a set of DSS Racing pistons. These are the forged pistons here. Standard bore and everything. Let's see. We have our rings, retainers, instructions, some stickers, and some pistons. What I'm gonna do now is actually set up a couple of these trays, or I'm gonna put each one of the cylinders on there and separate all the rings. Here's the setup. As you can see, I have all the pistons broken down with all the rings that go to each corresponding cylinder in their respective corners. What we do is we look at the instructions here that comes with the pistons, because they're gonna give you your recommended piston ring gap. You can see here for naturally aspirated, with maybe a mild power adder, maybe it's gonna be 6 thou ring gap. Just naturally aspirated is gonna be 5 thou. So we're gonna shoot for that 5 thou. I don't foresee me doing nitrous anytime soon, but maybe a turbo. So I'm gonna be shooting for that 5 thou ring gap here. As you see, I have the driver's side 1, 3, 5, and 7. And I have the tape peeled off the cylinder head here. I have you here on cylinder 1. You take the top ring, and all that you do is you just kind of start with a corner. Just kind of start it in there. Oh boy. And I don't know if you can see this or not. It's so tight. These are touching already. Yeah, that's touching. So you gotta remove some material. Okay, so when you're removing material here, less is always more. I'm just gonna push this up against the ring here like this. Yeah, then I'm just gonna take a small file. Take any burrs off. I know that this isn't gonna be enough at all, but I just wanna show you guys so you get the gist. Then you put it back in here. And then you just use the piston. Push on it and get it set in this as flat, but I can't push it in all the way. That's because we're hitting again, so I gotta take more off. But I know that I'm going the right direction because it fit. So I'm just gonna throw you guys on a time lapse because I got a crap ton of these to do. Okie dokie, so small problem here. As I was gapping the rings and stuff, I put the first ring into the cylinder and I noticed it was overlapping, and normally they don't give you that much material to remove when you are gapping your rings. Normally they're pretty close. I double checked my order, and I did order a set of standard bore pistons, but from the manufacturer, it looks like they sent me a set of oversized pistons. They're about, I think, 8 thou big is what they ended up being. So that leaves me with a couple of options and kind of in a pickle. I can either return these pistons and rods and wait until I get the standard bore set in, or I have these, I can just drop the block off at a machine shop, get it bored out a little bit, and get a little bit more work done while it's there maybe. So I took a couple of days to think about it. Like I said, it kind of threw me a curveball. But what I ended up deciding is that I am going to just rock what I have. They're a nice set of pistons, they're a nice set of rods, so I'll just stick with what I got and drop this off. I sent a couple of feelers out to a couple of different machine shops. Hopefully I'll be hearing back from them today. But what I'm gonna end up doing, quick rundown, I'm gonna get, while the machine shop has it, I'm gonna get some new cam bearings installed, and I'm gonna get the heads and the block resurfaced for the nice maintenance surface. And I'm gonna get it obviously overboard that 8 thou to make room for the new pistons and whatnot. Otherwise, everything else should be pretty standard, straightforward, nothing too crazy. It's like, it's a really, really mild bore. So it's basically a dusting off is all it's gonna be. But it'll be nice to have nice, fresh material everywhere and peace of mind with the cam bearings getting replaced. They're kind of a pain in the butt to do, so it'll be nice to have a shop that has the tools to actually go through and make sure that everything's nice and straight and round. Peace of mind. Really sucks. Wasn't expecting to have to do this, but in the end, maybe it'll work out. This is going to add a little bit of time onto the build. I'm still hopefully going to get it fired up this fall, but if for some reason the shop takes a little bit longer or whatever, things are crazy right now, then it might end up being a wintertime start. But if it does turn into a wintertime project, then maybe we'll end up running a nice single turbo, throw like 15 pounds of boost at it, or maybe we'll do 150 shot of nitrous, hook that up to it. Who knows? We have options, we have time. I want to do this right, I only want to do it once. So yeah, that means that I got to get the crank back out, which kind of sucks, and get all the assembly lube cleaned off of it and whatnot, but gotta do what you gotta do. So without further ado, we have a game plan. That's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna pull out the crank, making sure that I keep all the main bearings paired together because they worked before. The specs were all good. I wanna make sure that I keep them all the same. So I'm gonna pull this all back out and throw it back on the shelf, unfortunately, for now. But let's get this all knocked out. So obviously that's a huge bummer running into that issue, but it does open the door for a whole bunch of other possibilities that I'm super excited about. I hope you guys are super excited about it too. It's just gonna make the whole build that much better and hopefully make that much more horsepower, which is what we all want, right? So even though this might take a little bit, we got plenty of content coming your way. Point is, you aren't gonna miss anything, so make sure you're subscribed. Between the RX-7, the BRZ, the Crosstrek, the Sonic, Afton Civic, the go-kart, we got plenty of content coming your way. You aren't gonna miss anything. Make sure that you're subscribed. If you like what you saw, go ahead and leave a like. If you have any questions about what you saw, go ahead and leave a comment. Until next time, guys, we'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.